If you didn't know, Salesforce now has a direct integration with Jotform. So if you jump into Salesforce App Exchange, you can find it there and install Jotform inside. And you don't have to jump into Jotform every single time, just use it inside of Salesforce. So let's go check this out. So as I mentioned, Salesforce now integrates with Jotform. So if you jump over to App Exchange, search for Jotform, and go and get it right now. So once you go through the process of installation, you'll have Jotform inside of Salesforce. So no more jumping into Jotform to use it inside of Salesforce. So it's an easier integration. And when you create the forms inside of Salesforce for Jotform, it directly integrates with all the fields from Salesforce. So it's super smooth to use. Now, this is my Salesforce dashboard. And to get started with Jotform, once you have it installed, go into the app launcher, search for Jotform, go ahead and select it. And this is going to open up our Jotform panel. Now, this is how you're going to get started. And it's going to ask you to log in and allow Salesforce to connect one with another. Once that's done, go into Jotform with the next tab right here. And you're going to be able to view that we have a dashboard just like you would on Jotform, but without having to go to Jotform. So if you have team members working on Salesforce, you don't have to go back and forth to create forms that are going to be fillable to use on Salesforce. So right from here, we're going to be able to use Jotform. Now, it's the same and different in a way, okay? Once we create a form, this is where you're going to be able to view the changes. So I'm going to view a form and we can create from scratch. We can create a Salesforce form, use template, import form, and create a single document. Now, this is not available when you're over there on Jotform by itself. This is inside of Salesforce. And one of the beauties about this is that you can select one of the Salesforce objects of what you want to use this form for. And there's a huge list to use, and it creates the elements that we need. So if I want to do it for the account, it's going to let me know what elements that I can use that are already available on Salesforce. So it makes things easier and smoother, okay? So if I want to use these type of elements, so I'll select some of these, and there's a huge list for this particular one. There we go. I'll just select those for now. I'll create the form for this particular type that I want to do. And this is a Salesforce account form. And again, I can do everything that I want to edit. So it could be an account form. Doesn't have to say Salesforce if you like. The account name, I can go ahead and edit this. And you can see that every single field that I select has this. This field is connected to an account and account name. So it knows what field it's tied to on Salesforce, okay? Now, if I'm kind of worried of what fields I need, I can jump into this little icon right here that says Salesforce integration. I'll select that. I'll click on the gear icon. And again, I can view the elements, how they are tied one with another. I can get rid of elements and I can modify the elements. So if the billing city is different to the one I have over here, I'll select from the list and tie one with another, okay? So it's super easy to use. Now, once you have everything tied like the way you want it, go click next, and there's a new option here. Update an existing record. So that means that if someone fills it out with this off, it's gonna create a new record every single time. But if there's a duplicate of that form, it's gonna update it instead of creating a new one. So if something changes, like the phone number, the billing address, it's gonna update it instead of creating a new form, okay, over there on Salesforce. So here we go. I am going to select what element is it going to select to know that it's a duplicate form. In this case, I'll select account name, the field over here, account name. Again, I tie it one with another. I click save, and here we go. So if the account name is the same as a previous account on Salesforce, it's not going to create a new one. It's just going to replace the new information. So it's gonna get updated. So it's a pretty cool feature that we can use here on Salesforce with Jotform. So when everything is ready and smooth, go into publish. And when everything is ready, you can share this with a link. So I can go ahead and copy this link, open a new tab to see how it actually looks. So here's the form, but again, I can beautify that on the builder. I can share this with social media or create a QR code that I can display on my counter, or if I go to an expo, or for any reason you wanna use this form for, okay? So it's a pretty neat way to use all of this inside of Salesforce. So the direct integration is what really makes it shine, because the elements that are really available on Salesforce, you can use them right here without having to figure out which elements I need to create to obviously integrate with Salesforce. So like I said, jump over to the Salesforce App Exchange and install Jotform so you can use it inside of Salesforce. And that's a wrap for this new feature from Jotform and Salesforce.